You know what? 99% of the Excel users don't know this trick. You might be the first person in your office to know this. Well, in this video, we're going to learn three different methods to count colored cells in Excel. And make sure to download a free ebook at the end of this video where we have 100 ready-to-use VBA codes. So make sure to watch this video till the end. And now, let's get started. In the first method, we're going to use a custom function that will allow you to count colored cells the way you want. So in the first method, I have a VBA code that can help you to create a custom function that will allow you to count cells based on cell color and font color. So all you need to do is you need to go to your developer tab and click on Visual Basic Editor. And from here, you need to insert a new module and then paste this code. So I have already written this code. All you need to do is just add this code in your Visual Basic Editor. And then you need to come back to your workbook. And then you need to enter this function that is called count color cells. In this function, we have two arguments. In the first argument, you need to select the range where you have the cells. And then you need to select the cell where you have the color that you want to count. Now, simply close the function and hit enter. And it will give you the result. That is two cells we have here where we have this color, which is, you know, a little bit equivalent to a pink color. But if I change this color, for example, if I just copy this color here and then I change the color here, that is light green, it will instantly change the count of cells that we have, because we have four cells in this range which have the light green color. Now, moving forward, I have one more code that will help you to count cells based on the font color instead of cell colors. So again, you need to go to your developer tab and then click on Visual Basic Editor. And here you need to paste this code, which will again create a new function. And let me add a font here with the red color. This is the value. And now I'm going to enter my function that is called count font color cells. Again, I need to select the range where I have the cells and then the cell where I have the color font color. And then I'm going to close the function. And it returns 2 because we have 2 cells with the red font color in this range. Now, I have 2 more functions that will help you to count cells based on the color. So these codes basically will allow you to have 2 more functions. And let me paste it here. So again, as I said, you need to go to your developer tab, click on Visual Basic, and then by inserting a new module, you can add your codes here. Now, this third code that creates a third function is basically a combination of both of these codes. So this single function will allow you to count cells based on font color and cell color. All you need to do is just to specify which method you want to use. So if I go back to my worksheet and then if I remove these earlier functions, and now let me add this new function that is the third function, count color cells AD. Now, when I enter this function and then I select the range and then the cell where I have the cell color, now I need to specify that with which method I want to go. Let's say I want to count cells based on cell color. So I need to define 0 and then close the function and hit enter. It returns the result for the cell color. But if I want to count, based on font color, let me insert the function again, select the range, select the cell where I have the font color, and then in the third argument, I need to define 1. So if you want to go with cell color, you need to define 0 in the third argument. And if you want to go with the font color, you need to go with the value 1. And if you skip specifying the third argument, it will automatically by default go with the cell color. And now let me hit enter to get the result, the count of cells based on the font color. So this is how this function works. So you can use any of these functions depending on your requirement. In this method, we'll create a helper column and then we'll count the colored cells from the data. All right, so in this method, this is the second method, create a helper column, and then we're going to use function to count total number of cells that has a particular cell color or font color. So first of all, you need to select the cell B1 because we have cells with color in the column A. So I'll select cell B1 and then I'll go to my formula tab, and then from here, I'm going to click on name manager and then click on new. Now I'm going to use a name here, and in the reference to, I'm going to use a function that is called get.cell. Now this function is not available in Excel's worksheet, but you can use this function in VBA, and this function is basically there in VBA for compatibility. Now, in this function, you need to use this code 38 that refers to the interior cell color of a particular cell. And here I'm specifying cell A1. As you can see, I have selected B1 and I am using the reference cell A1. So whenever you use this name range, it will always return the code for cell color, which is previous. Let's say if I'm entering this in cell B1, it will always return cell color for the cell A1. Let me show you how this works. Now, when I go back and enter get cell color, you can see it automatically refers to the previous cell from B1 to A1. And now when I hit enter, it returns a code that defines the color of the cell. Now let me drag this down. And now I'm gonna use a simple function to count total number of cells with particular cell color. So I'll use count if, and I'm gonna select the range. And now for using the criteria, instead of, you know, specifying cell, I'll simply use get cell color. So it will give me criteria from the cell A12. And now when I close the function and hit enter, it returns 4. That means there are 4 cells in this range where I have the color light green. And let me freeze this range. And now when I drag this down, it returns count of cells for the light yellow and then the light pink color. And in the same way, you can also create a formula that can help you to get count of cells with a particular font color. All right. So for this, again, I'm going to select the cell B1 and then in my formulas tab, I'm going to go to name manager and then click on new. And let me enter a new name, get font color. And here in the refers to, I'm going to add the same function, but this time I have a different code, that is 24. And this 24 code helps you to get the code for font color instead of cell color. And now when I click OK and come back and let me enter get font color and let me hit enter. So it returns a code, a particular code for the font color. And let me again use the count if function, select the range and again use the custom name that we have created for getting the font colors code, get font color and then just hit enter to get the count. And let me freeze this range so that I can drag the formula down. And here again, we have count of cells with the particular font color. For green, we have 4. For yellow, again, we have 4. And for red, we have 2 cells. Now, this method is quite easy because we're going to use normal filter and a function that will allow us to count colored cells, which are actually filtered cells.
So first of all, you need to enter subtotal function. And in the first argument of subtotal, you need to specify 3. That means we're using this function count A. Now, in the second argument, you need to select the range where you have all the cells with the color. And then you need to close your function. So we have 3 and then the range where we have, you know, colored cells. Now it shows me the count of total cells that I have in this range. But when I apply a filter and then I use filter by color, let's say if I filter green cells, it gives me the count of all those green cells, the cells with the green color. And in the same way, if I want to count cells with the font color, which is brown, it gives me the count. So this is also a way to count colored cells if you don't want to use any of the methods we have discussed earlier.